Hello and welcome back to Tea with Tracy. Coming to you live every Tuesday at 12, spilling relevant tips, trends, and talk in all things real estate and home ownership related. Today, we are continuing on with our local business spotlight series. And today's local business is near and dear to my heart, DOBI Real Estate. Joining us today, I have founder and CEO of DOBI Real Estate, Simon Thomas. Without further ado, let's get Simon on to join us. Simon!
Hello.
How are you? All right.
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic. So I have you on joining us today. I'm in the middle of a local business spotlight series, and who better than to have on is you, founder and CEO of DOBI Real Estate. It's where I choose to hang my real estate license. Very proud to be part of the team at DOBI. So thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah,
I love it.
Absolutely. So DOBI is a local real estate company in the Metro Detroit area. But as many of you may or may not know, as real estate agents, we are licensed throughout the entire state. So some of us do have a farther reach. But tell us, Simon, because you were a very successful agent on your own. You built a team and then you decided to start DOBI. You decided you wanted to become a broker and start your own real estate company. Tell us why and what you wanted DOBI to be that was not what you were currently experiencing.
Yeah, when I got into real estate, which was 10 years ago this month, I've been in real estate and I enjoyed selling. I had no intentions of starting a brokerage. It was not even a thought in my mind that was a goal of mine. I really enjoyed being on my own, selling real estate. Eventually I hired a great assistant, Rena, who's now our head of operations here and growing into an unbelievable role. But, you know, doing a lot of business, really just accountable for myself. And every time I made a paycheck, it was mine. I grew up in traditional businesses where, you know, you bring in all this money, but you have all this overhead, and brick and mortar was something that did not excite me. But after doing this business for 7 years, and becoming doing a lot of volume, doing 50, 60 units in a year, there was a lot of things at the brokerages I was at. They're great brokerages. I don't want to say that. These guys are amazing. But there was things that I realized they were missing. And I used to say, like, man, it'd be great if they did this. It'd be great if they did that. And I didn't want to keep moving brokerages looking for that, because I realized I did move it. Within 7 years, I moved a couple times and I realized they're all kind of the same.
Right.
And I said, you know what, I want to be in this business. I was 32, 33 at the time. And I realized I want to be in this business for a long time, but I don't want to keep moving. So if we're looking for this and it's not out there, then maybe we should do it ourselves. And it kind of was like, all right, let's do it.
Yeah.
And I do believe in when you do something, you do it right.
Yep.
But I couldn't believe I was getting onto this side of things, because I was very content and happy with growing my sales business. But now, you know, thinking like an agent, knowing what agents are going through, it's a big reason, I think, for why DOBI has gotten to 100 agents the last 3 years and is doing what we're doing.
Well, yeah. And I can speak that. So Simon, for those of you who don't know Simon personally, Simon truly cares about people. So the agents within DOBI, just people in general. So there's a very different vibe, a different culture, a different feel at DOBI. We are all very focused, and we like to refine our skills when it comes to business. But there is a family feel, a family atmosphere. Everybody helps each other. There's synergies. One of our core values is come together. And we definitely do that very well. You've created an environment where everybody is so willing to help one another. And that actually starts with the staff. We have such an awesome staff. I know we had our last brokerage meeting of the year and then our Christmas party last week, and I was talking with several agents and some of the newer agents that just came to our office, and they couldn't believe how willing and helpful everyone on the staff is. And I chimed in and I said, yes, even when we're the ones being unreasonable, not that we ever are, but the staff is always like, smile on their face, let me see what I can do, because they know that the more that they support us, that the more we can support our clients, which is what we love to do. And that's what I think. Well, that's, I know what attracted me to DOBI. You know?
Yeah, I agree. And I do think that's a big reason why we're winning right now. And I think, you know, this business is very stressful. You know, again, I relate back to when I was selling and doing, you know, a lot of units, and I'd go back to the office and I was like, go in my office and I was by myself. And it's just, you get beat up all day. You have good things that happen all day, but you know, you also have, you know, when you're talking about deal flow and dealing with people all day, you have challenges all day long. And I, you know, going into the office needs to be a place where you go to, you know, get served and be pampered a little bit and make sure if there is something we can jump in and help with, you know, we can do that to take a little bit of the stress off. That's why you pay your fees, you know, and you're a client of ours. And that's, you know, that's how I look at it. And, you know, I say, you know, when we build something out here, when we respond, when we do something here, I say, if I was an agent, would I like this? You know, would our agents like this? And would it take stress off? Does it make them more efficient? Does it, you know, does it benefit the agent? And that's just kind of like the mindset with every decision we make. And it started with building the right staff. I mean, you have to have people when they walk in, their energy has to be right. They have to be smiling. They have to be willing and able and confident all the time for you guys. Cause it's a really, really big deal for agents. Cause it's probably one of the toughest businesses in the world to go out there and make a living. Because 24/7 and there's no salary, it's 100% right. commission, and you got to, right. and there's a lot of us, there's a lot of right. agents out there. So energy is a big deal and we take it very serious here.
Yes. And it really is. It's a fantastic environment and there's something for everyone. I feel, you know, one of the other things that I really love about DOBI is that, we help the community, right? DOBI participates every year. We support a different charity. And so DOBI matches, if agents want to participate, it's their option to, and then DOBI makes matches and we give a quite a nice contribution to a different local charity, adopt a family. There's always a different event that you can be doing to support our community. And that is, I like that as well. I was actually, yesterday we were in the office, some of the women of DOBI, we had a fun photo shoot. And some of us were talking that if we could do volunteer work 24/7, like that's what we would do. So having, you know, being a part of a brokerage where we actually get to incorporate that into what we do is really meaningful.
Yeah. And I think like you talked about our core value come together, you know, and I think, you know, community and give back is something that I really want to take to the next level here at DOBI. But, you know, we're just over 3 years old. Mm-hmm. And in the beginning, you really have a lot of systems and processes. And we're not a 100-year-old company. We're not a franchise. We're an independent that we started this thing 3.5 years ago is in our mind and now we're building it. We didn't have somebody telling us what this is how you do and the blueprint and all the documents and all the structures and you know, all the systems and processes. We didn't have anything. So the last three and a half years, and we had no agents, right? In the beginning.
Right.
So the last four years has really been just building that and the brand and getting people to believe in us in any type of community and any type of give back we could do, we were in, but it was really hard to go, you know, all in on something like that. Now, moving forward, we're seeing it's just, what's the point of working this hard if you can't help other people? I mean, I really do believe in that. And it's sincere when I say that. And a lot of people think, oh, you're doing it for marketing. No, I'm not doing this for marketing. I do see that when these agents are working towards something to come together to help a family or to donate, you know, $10,000 in a month because everybody made a lot of money and the market's hot right now. And we can help a bunch of kids, you know, who don't have the means for to have an unbelievable holiday season, and we can help with that. I see the value in that, and it really makes us feel good. You know, I mean, and I do. I see people like you, Tracy, work with other agents, and I'm like, that's DOBI, right? Like really coming together. And yeah, we're coming together to do deals to help each other grow our businesses 100%. But I truly believe that here at DOBI, like the next phase of community, you know, we have visions to, you know, now when Tracy does well, the whole company, you know, they're rooting for you because at the end of the day, if you do really well in a traditional brokerage, it doesn't really mean anything to the other agents, right?
Right.
So everyone's rooting for each other to do well because we're working towards one big thing. And that's a vision that we've been talking about for a while, but we really had to get systems and processes in place. And now we do, and we're ready to go and really take it to the next level. And we're super excited for 2022 and what we can do in the lives we can really change, you know?
Absolutely. And you know what, Simon, you'd never know that there was a lot of work going on in the back end, because again, on the front side, it always, I mean, just such a positive forward moving vibe and attitude and energy, and really is fantastic. Now, moving forward, we know there's great things coming for DOBI, but before we sign off for today, what are your thoughts on the real estate market for 2022?
You know, it's a question that I've been getting asked for 7-10 years now since I've gotten in the business. What do you see? I don't think anybody was ever right when they gave their predictions. I think when you look at COVID, we were all scared. Oh my God, here we go. Get ready for this roller coaster ride to the bottom, right? That's what everyone was thinking. And then it was the exact opposite. It was a roller coaster ride to the top. You know, I think that as long as interest rates are low, we're going to be okay. Yeah. We do have very, very, very low inventory right now. So that is a challenge, because we do have a lot of people who are saying, I will sell my home, but if I sell it, because I know I'm going to sell it very quickly, where am I going to go?
Right.
So I think we're going to battle that for a while. But what that means for realtors is each unit's going to be worth more money to us. We may do a little less, but volume sales-wise, commission-wise, we'll probably do okay. As a buyer or seller, I would say, you know, for a seller, get your house on the market, right? You're going to make a lot of money. Make sure all the terms are in your favor. Work with a great realtor and they can work on getting new occupancy after, but
we won't let you go homeless.
Yeah. We won't let you go homeless, and it's all working out.
Yes.
So, but I do think the market's going to be great for a little while. I don't see what, you know, in 08, when that stuff happened, you know, there was a lot of other challenges, the way they pre-approved you. Getting a loan today is not easy.
Right.
So, you know, they're giving out better quality loans, and their underwriting process is way better. So do I see a dip, you know, in 2 to 3 years? Yes. But, you know, I don't see it. That actually could be a good thing for us, but it's going to be, I think it's going to continue to be a low inventory, hot market for sellers.
Yep.
And on the end with the buy side, you got to be patient, go see as many houses as possible, and don't be afraid to write offers, and stay within your means.
Be ready. You know, like I tell all of my clients, inform decisions and be ready to go. Like you said, I think all the indicators are there that 2022 is still going to be a very strong year, for real estate. So, if you've been considering making a move before those interest rates do go up, because they have to at some point, and you want to lock something in, then you want to make sure that you do it sooner rather than later. So
100%. Yeah. 100%. So it's exciting. It's exciting and stressful and emotional. It's all these things at one time, right?
It's unbelievable. I don't consider myself, you know, some people say, you know, in real estate, you're in sales. I don't consider myself a salesperson at all. More of a counselor, an advisor, you know.
A marriage counselor.
Yeah,
sometimes
relationship counselor. Yes. Whatever their needs are, that's what we're here for, right? So, well, thank you so much for joining us, Simon. Thank you so much for all that you do for DOBI, for the community. I appreciate you. We appreciate you. And thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you. We appreciate you, and we love having you. As much as you love being here, we love having you, and I love watching your business grow. The Tea with Tracy, I watch it weekly. I love it, so keep it going. And you really are, I mean, you really are an unbelievable realtor in person. So we're excited to keep going.
Thank you so much. And thank you all for tuning in. I'm excited to bring you these editions each week. Next week, we are going to be finishing out our local business series edition. So tune in for a very special episode next week, Tuesday at 12. Thanks again, Simon. Thank you all for tuning in.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.